When you create toolpaths in and route, one of the things that you can do is you can look at statistics regarding cut time and that sort of thing. So you just come in here and click on statistics, and it'll bring up information about how much of a cut distance there is, feed distance, that sort of thing, and then an estimate of the time that it'll take based on the parameters that have been defined in preferences for the cut statistics. So one of the things that we've added in the ATP is the ability to get that information also. So what we can do here, if we process a job that has certain number of parts and that sort of thing and is set up, I'm going to tell it to create a printout of the parts and then process the job. So one of the things you notice when you get the output here is this has changed, where it tells you where the file is created, and then it also gives you an information about cut length and the amount of time estimated that a particular job will take. And so that's now provided in this summary. And then I'm going to create the printouts here, and I've just had them written out to a PDF. So I've created those outputs. Now if I open up the files in the PDF, let's come here. Here we are in sheet one. You'll see that as part of the printout here, it looks pretty similar to what it was before, but we have added an estimate of the cut length and the cut time that will be required. And so now this is provided here as an estimate, and should be good information for users to use, and a good way to estimate the amount of time that each particular sheet is going to take. So you see that it's included in the printout, and then it was also included in the results that were reported when the ATP processed. So that's now cut statistics that are provided as part of the ATP processing.